Be Mommy with Style. Today I wanted to share a review of the Fire 7 with Alexa. This is a little travel tablet that I got to read and use as an e-reader and also use for games and things like that whenever we're traveling. So you can see that it's got a small size, and so it should be really portable. It should fit down inside my purses or if I'm using like a travel tote. I did buy this case separately. It's a Fintie case, and it'll be on my Amazon list down below if you want to check it out. They have these in a number of different sizes, and I went ahead and got the 7 because this is what the kids have as well. I'm trying to pop it out of there so you can see. So this is the case that I bought separately, and the brand on that is Fintie. I really love this color. And I also ended up getting this kind of turquoise color, the teal, for the case or the outside shell on the Fire as well. So I got the 7. It was a really awesome deal. They have like flash sales sometimes. I happened to log in one day and they had these Fires on like a flash, super flash sale, and you could get this for like $34. It was so cheap. So I went ahead and got this because I thought it would be a good purse size, and I thought if I liked it and it worked out well, then I could get like either the 8 or the 10 later on as a larger one when I'm gonna be doing a lot of traveling for work coming up. So this is the box that it came in. It was really easy to set up, and it does use the same cord as the kids' tablets. They have the kids' Amazon Fires with the free time on them, and they have the squishy cases that came around the outside. You know, so if they drop them or whatever, it works, it keeps it safe. So we are familiar with these tablets from using those, and it has the same kind of USB cord here, and it came with this and plugs in with the same type of charger here on the side. Then on the top it has 2 volume buttons and then the on off button, so it's really super easy to use, and I was already familiar with that again because of the kids. It's got the kind of speakers, microphone area right here, and then this case that I got actually has holes in it as well, so that will come through. So this is the first time I've really set one up for myself though, because the only ones we've had in the past were for the kids. So I've been enjoying checking this out. We do have Amazon Prime, we're Prime members, and so that's why these work particularly well for us, because we get a lot of free shows and free videos and books and all those sorts of things that can go on here when you're an Amazon Prime member. So across the top, it's got a kind of scroll menu. You can scroll back and forth. I'm anticipating that I'll use it a lot for books, and you can see I have a lot of kids' books recommendations on here because the kids, I order things for the kids a lot on my account. So it really thinks that I'll like Magic Treehouse books. So it's gonna have to learn my preferences, not just what I buy for the kids. But I downloaded a couple of business-oriented books that I could hopefully read during my travels on there. And then it's also got a video area. I'm a Prime member again, so any of the Prime shows like The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel, what else have we watched on here? The Jack Ryan Show, we've been watching that. Things like that are Amazon Prime specific, and then like Sex and the City, I would probably watch that a lot when I'm traveling because it's one of those shows that I can just like binge watch and watch episode after episode. So it'll probably end up being my travel show. But we also watch shows like Doctor Who and stuff like that on Amazon Prime as well. So it's cool because it syncs up with stuff that we may have bought and that sort of thing. So like we bought some of the Descendants videos. So if I'm traveling like and have it synced up, the kids could even watch it on mine as well. And I also wanted to get this instead of just getting an e-reader. I wanted to get the Fire instead of like just a Kindle or like the Paperwhite, because when I'm waiting, you know, like say I'm waiting to board an airplane, I don't really want to like get absorbed into a book. I'd really more read once I'm actually flying and that sort of thing. But say it's 20 minutes till we're boarding and I just want to, you know, do something to kind of occupy my mind. I do like these jewel games a lot, and I like games like that just to kind of fill those little spaces, but where I don't want to be totally distracted. Because when I start reading and if I get really absorbed into something, I can kind of block out everything around me. So I could see it being an issue that I just block out boarding and it's like, oh no, I gotta go catch the plane. So typically that's what I do, is if I'm reading, I just do it during the flight or while we're driving or, you know, whatever the case may be. And then I like games like Two Dots or Bejeweled and stuff like that on here as well. I have downloaded the social media, but of course I have my phone too. So I don't know that I'll really use social media here on that much, so we'll see. You can also connect it to your Amazon account and, you know, download any music or anything like that. There's Disney hits, so we could use this to listen to music when we're in the hotel room. But then also you can order things from here as well. So if you connect it with your Amazon account, if you're a frequent Amazon shopper like I am, you can get on the Amazon account or use it through the browser on here and order some things. I actually tested that out like literally the first night that I got it. And then there's the newsstand. There's a couple of different places if you're, you know, super into catching up with news. You can do that, and there's Audible on here. I actually prefer to read books as opposed to listen to them. So I don't, again, know how much that I will use that, but it does think that this audiobook of Keeper of Lost Cities is a recommended title for me. So again, I'm gonna have to retrain my Fire. But all in all, I mean, I'm liking it. We were pretty familiar with these. I think it's a really great, straightforward, inexpensive tablet. I mean, I got, normally I think these are like $49.99 or $59.99. And I got this for, I mean, it was like a flash sale. I had just been looking at them, and then I happened to randomly just check it again for some reason, and it was like flash deal, $34.99, and I was like, well, add to cart, check out. You know, it's like not even worth thinking about what I wanted to use at that point because it was so cheap. Plus, I love this color that it is. So this is a great way just to kind of try it out, see if it's for you. I wanted to see what I thought about the size. I thought 8 inches might be a good compromise, but then it's not that much bigger than this. And so I want to see how much I use it. And then if I think that I'd be using it to watch videos a lot and things like that, when I'm traveling for work and going to different cities, then I might get the 10 and just like use something like this on the plane and use like the 10 in the hotel room. So anyhow, I thought this was a cute little case too. And it's got this deal where it can roll up and you can, you know, I don't know why this keeps popping up updates, but anyhow, you can roll it up and you can sit up here. So I was actually testing it out the other day. I was sitting there watching Sex in the City and testing it out. I have downloaded a number of things because there are certain things you have to download, like the books and things like that. I probably will always have like a couple movies and books. I think this is one of the smaller ones that you can get. It's only 16 gigs, but like it functions like the kids. They actually have a little mini SD card in theirs that can expand the memory, so I wasn't really that concerned about how much memory came in it. Let's see here. My husband usually deals with all that stuff, but right here, there's a place where you can upload a little mini SD card, and we usually always have extras of those laying around. So it's a really comprehensive, just good little tablet, and they've really come down in price. They're pretty inexpensive, so it's a great option, especially if you have Amazon Prime. I mean, why not? Because you get so many like free books and stuff like that. And you can download games and things like that. And so I think it should be a good travel buddy. So that is my my thought and kind of wrap up on the Fire 7. I do think it's definitely worth the money. I think they're a pretty inexpensive tablet. And from our experience, the kids have had the kids' Fire versions for a number of years and they use the free time on it. They're a really great way to kind of limit what the kids can use on there, limit down the times. We have it set to where the kids' Fires turn off at 7:30. Obviously, I won't have that kind of limits on mine. But for the kids' Fire versions with the free time on them, they work really, really well as far as setting limits. They have to do a certain number of educational things or a certain amount of reading, or they're only allowed to do so much app time during a day. And you can change it. So if you're traveling, you're obviously going to be on airplanes for 5 hours that day or whatever, you can up it. But just on a general day, if you want it set at a certain level, it's a really great way to kind of keep a handle on that and kind of work with your own personal policies and stuff like that. So all in all, I think I'm going to like it. Positive review so far. I've only had it for a very short time period, but we have been pretty well acquainted with these, so I'm pretty comfortable with it. I think it should be a good little travel case. You can kind of see it here next to my iPhone 7 Plus, so it's not really that much bigger than this, but it should be a great size to fit down in my purse and not be too bulky, which was kind of my main goal. When I'm traveling, I would usually have like this, my phone, a card case. I typically wouldn't have keys or anything like that in my main travel bag, so I try to kind of really limit what I have to lug around an airport or whatever so it's not bulky, so I think this should work out great. So that is it for today. Let me know if you have any questions down below, and I'll see you in another video very soon. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.